old man used to tell me when I was just a boy. He was blessed because he had a job that he enjoyed. Not everyone would like it, but to him its main appeal was the breathing of the bellows and the ringing of the steel. I started working early, holding horses for my pa. 'Twas a little town we lived in, only one man had a car. And the old man used to watch him whenever he drove past. He said, "It's just a fad, you know, it's never gonna last." All around the forge, the old man strolled, grabbed a bit of iron, shoved it in the coals. He was good at what he did, and he cut an honest deal amongst the breathing of the bellows and the ringing of the steel. The old man's head got greyer, but that didn't slow him down. He kept on shoeing horses that brought from round the town. He showed me bits and pieces, and before too long I could make a decent set of shoes and shape and whack 'em on. We'd sometimes have a shoeing race and sweat from start till end. The old man was the master, but sometimes he'd let me win. And a crowd of eager passers-by would watch the mad ordeal amongst the breathing of the bellows and the ringing of the steel. Well, after years of teaching, after years of toil, the old man was buried deep in mountain soil. I kept on with the shoeing, but the job was in recess. The old man wasn't right about the motor car, I guess. Now I've all but had it, and the forge is very quiet, but I heat the coals up now and then and tinker around inside. I'd do it for the old man and remember how I'd feel amongst the breathing of the bellows and the ringing of the steel. Ringing off the steel.